We are driving through the most picturesque scenery, just endless green fields and little villages. All of them have churches that you see from far away. Livio just went off course by 3 miles and we had to go back. You push me to the limit. I'm feeling for the edge. You're picking up my pieces. I'm climbing up the stairs. All the way up to your lips. And I'm high right now than I've ever been. For our next destination in Transylvania, Livio and I have come to the city of Brasov. Brasov is one of the 7 walled citadels built by the Saxons in the Middle Ages, and it was established in 1234, so it is a very old city. I wonder where you're going, wonder where you've been. I forgot how to dream until now. I'd carry you around all over this town. Do anything for a kiss. Your touch. Liv, doesn't this make us look like princesses? Back on the road. The sweetest lie, no complications. We're both changing side by side. We have found ourselves. Livio, where did you bring me?
To Caleb Casale.
This place is amazingly beautiful, and look where Livio booked for us. This is our house.
That one there. What? There somewhere?
This is literally our house where we're staying in the shadow of a mountain.
Back.
Isn't there another mountain here?
Yeah, there's another one. Wow, that's huge.
This is so cool.
That's really huge.
Yeah. Let's go inside the house. These hills, can hear the cowbells in the distance.
from this herd of cows. It's really sad though, because a lot of this area is, what would you call it, that they're logging here? Livio, what would you call it?
They're logging here? And it looks terrible.
And you said it's illegal logging? Where are you?
Yeah, most of it is illegal logging. So
it's awful because you just see so many of these hills with the trees all cut down. And at our cabin, I was looking out the window for a while last night, and you just see all of these huge trucks going by all the time with so many logs on them that they've just cut. And some of these hills are just completely stripped bare of the forest. And I mean, this is one of the most beautiful forests I've ever seen, and it's just so sad and awful to see that. So I really hope that they can stop that, and that this place is gonna be here just as it is for a long, long time. Did just want to talk a little bit more about the deforestation that I saw when I was in the Bicaz Gorge and that area. And that is just so sad to see, because from the second that I stepped foot in the area, that I got out of the car, I could just feel how pure and pristine everything felt there. It's kind of hard to describe, but the air felt pure, and the bird songs were actually the loudest sound. The mountain streams going by, and this water is so crystal clear, just coming from mountain springs, that there's various points alongside the road where you can just stop and drink. You can just get water straight out of the mountain, and that's how clean it is. Bicaz Gorge is located in the Eastern Carpathian Mountains. A notable fact about the forests of these mountains are that they are old growth forests, or some people call them virgin forests, and that means that the way that they've been, their ecosystem has been the same for hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of years. So to get that back would take hundreds of years. So these forests are becoming more and more rare throughout the world, and this is one of the last ones in all of Europe. Very recently, actually about a month before I was there, Romania took action against a huge illegal logging ring believed to be the biggest yet seen in all of Europe. 25 million euro operation, that's almost $30 million. It is not allowed for people to just take all of the trees from a hill and just leave everything stripped bare, because that obviously leaves the forest no chance of ever recovering. What they are supposed to do is, maybe there's 10 trees in a little area, take one tree and then move on, just take one tree, and that is sometimes allowed with permits and such. But they obviously aren't always doing that, because I saw so many hills that are just stumps everywhere. Another thing that supposedly the illegal loggers are doing is they get a paper that says they're allowed to go. They have to present it to the police on their way out, and the police keep it, and then they're not allowed to go back. However, what they do is they just pass by the police. They don't seek them out and hope that the police don't stop them and say, hey, you know, where's your paper? And then they go back and just keep getting more and more and more loads, even though they're only authorized for one, because the police haven't taken that paper yet. And then when the police finally do catch them, they just hand in their paper and say, oh yeah, we were coming to give it to you. This is our one load, even though they have gotten maybe 5 or 6 loads. Also, people that do have the permits and are working with companies that maybe aren't breaking the law, they are then saying to illegal companies, hey, I'm going out with this company. I can add on a lot of other trees for you if you pay me. This area is so beautiful, and I hope that it's still there to see for all of you guys, and for a long, long time. All right, guys, well, thank you so much for watching. Be sure to subscribe here if you haven't already, and go follow me on Instagram. Next week on this channel, Friday the 13th, coming out is my vampire video, and I'm very excited about it. The history of vampires relating to Romania and castles and such. In her hands is my heart.
and she won't let go till it's gone. Try to breathe, but I can't.
I'll see you next time. Bye.